Knights of Apollo, what's up guys? It's Pixelated Apollo. Thanks for stopping by. Hope you guys are doing well, and today we have a fantastic siege battle. This one is really good. Everything that you could dream of in a siege battle, it's right here right now. You got the snowy epic atmosphere, tons of troops, infantry fighting to the death, archers firing left and right, cav, catapults, death, destruction, fire, siege towers, walls crumbling. It's going to be fantastic. Now, this is a fairly long battle, but it's non-stop action. There's no slow parts in this fight. Also, it's very close. It is down to the wire. You will not be able to determine who's going to win this one until the final few seconds. So I don't say this all the time, but this battle is most definitely snack and drink worthy. So get somewhere comfortable, get a snack, get a drink, and enjoy the slaughter. So this, of course, is the Seven Kingdoms mod for Total War Attila. It's still in closed alpha, but hopefully soon, fingers crossed, they will release it to the public. Now the scenario for this battle, it's made up, but it's plausible. I can see this happening. The North is rebelling. They want to be independent, and we have some houses from the Riverlands that are going to be helping them in this rebellion. And to crush this rebellion, we have House Lannister and House Tyrell. So they've got very professional, very elite armies ready to march into the settlement and destroy everyone standing in their way. So let's go ahead, look at the army comps. Oh wait, before we do that, let me explain what's going on here. So this is a 1v1 between me and Jackie Fish. We both have AI armies just to spice it up, just to add more soldiers on the battlefield. It's really crazy having AI allies. They do some stupid stuff, but it's also fun. Oh my goodness. All right, I gotta watch this. Oh, rip in peace. That falling animation, pretty goofy. But yeah, the AI really stupid here, just leaving their troops up on the walls, getting tons of or losing tons of troops. Let's go ahead and look at the army comps, and then we can get this one started. We'll start with Jackie Fish's side. So he is leading House Lannister. He's got two units of light swordsmen. He has a bunch of heavy infantry, just like a ton. It's ridiculous. So there they are. They look so cool. And then back here, he has two units of heavy spearmen. He has some cav back here, the Lannister heavy cavalry, and then here is his general Tywin Lannister. He is the mastermind of this assault. Now looking at House Tyrell, he's got, well, this is the AI army, and they are bringing a lot of heavy swordsmen, medium infantry or medium swordsmen, and I think a couple light swordsmen. He has some cav in the back and some archers, and that's pretty much it for his army. Let's move on to the defenders. We're gonna go a little bit slower with the defenders because there's a lot of houses that we haven't seen yet before. So starting with the North, we have House Karstark. They are bringing some light swordsmen, so let me go ahead and zoom in here. Pretty cool looking, pretty nice. And then back here we have, what is this, House Umber. Yes, House Umber. So let's move in, or zoom in, I should say, and look at the light swordsman. Nice detail. Look at that beard. That's a, you know, you might want to clean up that beard a little bit, you know. And then back here, he has some Mormont's heavy swordsmen. Let's zoom in on these guys. I like the shields with the bear on it. Looks pretty cool. And then I think that's pretty much it. He's got more. Let's see, Karstark heavy infantry here. They look pretty sweet. I like the shields. Very cool design. Let's see. Glover. Oh, we got House Glover heavy spearmen. Nice. Look at that fist. They're ready to go. They're ready to fight. And that's pretty much it for their army. Let's move on to the Riverlands, which is the faction I am commanding. There's only two different houses. We've got House Bracken. Very awesome looking sigil and uniforms. They look pretty professional. Good to go. So I've got a lot of swordsmen, a lot of spearmen. You can see the spears back here. I'm bringing two units of light cav, which are also javelin cav, so they have javelin capabilities. So they're pretty nasty, especially if you can use those javies. So that's my cav force. And then back here, I've got a catapult waiting in reserve. My general is Blackfish. So he's leading the rebellion. I don't know why he's not with his own bannermen, but whatever. And then I have a couple units from Malister. So House Malister, they've got a really cool color scheme, nice purple with a really cool eagle, very similar to the coat of arms for the Knights of Apollo. So yeah, pretty sweet. They only brought a handful of troops to help the rebellion. But let's go ahead, do normal speed, and begin the battle. Alright, so here we go. We can see the AI is, well, they're not completely stupid. The AI will send everyone to defend the outer walls. And the cool thing about having AI is that they actually set up some defenses here. So we're going to have some barricades protecting the streets, which is something that we don't get to see all the time, because if you try to put down barricades, the replay will crash. So I'm pretty excited to use that, you know, put some troops behind there and defend the streets. Let's see what's going on with House Tyrell. Seems like they're going to move in first. Jackie Fish was telling me that, you know, he's going to let Tyrell do all that, the heavy lifting, breaking through the front lines, and then he will move in his army. So we'll see what happens here. This is, you know, we were playing this live, obviously. You know, we were chatting and we were talking a lot of crap to each other. You know, it's a pretty intense battle. A part of me wished I recorded it live, because it got pretty intense at certain parts. House Glover getting a little anxious there. Moving out his troops. Oh man, look at this scene right here. Look at this. Look at that. All the siege towers in the background moving in. And then let's see if these spearmen actually engage the enemy. Wow, what bravery. What guts. They're actually, they're going in. Yes, they are. No, they're not. Yes, they are. What is this formation? I don't even remember this happening. I guess I was just focused elsewhere. What AI? Let's see if they fight. No, he's falling back. Okay, very interesting tactics there from House Glover. Should definitely just sit back and defend the walls. I don't know what you're doing, Glover. And then here comes the first ladder from Tyrell. We got some heavy swordsmen coming up. So cool, the banners are on their backs. Look at that. There they go, the first regiment moving forward, ready to take the walls against the rebellion. Well, it looks like the archers are falling back, which is actually pretty smart from the AI. You know, they don't want to get caught out. But the archers are firing now at enemy forces. Nope, never mind. They're falling back. And just look at the point of view. Imagine being on this wall, seeing that massive army ready to kill you. It's got to be very terrifying. If we look at my forces, I'm still trying to march my way over there. I don't want to rush them over there because I don't want them tired. But the AI, they still have a ton of troops defending this area, so I should have plenty of time. So this is where Jackie Fish, she's now moving in some swordsmen. I guess he decided to support Tyrell's advance because they are not going through the choke points, so he's going to be the first one to send them in. It's going to get a little framey. I think I said that earlier, but it is going to get a little framey because of the AI and the amount of troops. So here we go, a very bold charge from House Umber, sending in their light swordsmen. Jackie Fish now going into moving or attacking Testudo. It almost looks like they're fighting on ice. Look at that. It's like this this castle had a moat and it froze. So there they go, they're charging in. We got a lot of reserves waiting, like House Glover. More light infantry getting into position. Let's go ahead and zoom out here. Look at this army. This is awesome. It's so cool. The AI, just nice organized force there from the AI, which is always good to see. Here comes more and more troops. Tyrell. I was just going to let them take the walls because the AI is pretty stupid when taking walls. They're really indecisive. They seem to go back and forth, not really sure what to do. So I figured that I would just protect the streets here and then have archers and skirmishers just firing down at the troops who are at the walls, because they would just get peppered down, just stand there and die. So yeah, there goes Jackie Fish's ally, charging in. He claims the walls, but for how long? For how long? All right, so here comes House Lannister, finally getting over the breach point. Let me go ahead and zoom in on this fight. So there's a lot of troops in one area, that's for sure. But he's making sure to have a lot of reserves. He doesn't want to send everyone at once. And I think they are still fighting over the gate. Actually, Tyrell. Oh yeah, that's right. Tyrell gets really, like, they bug out here and they don't move forward the rest of their troops. Because look, they've got plenty of siege towers. They have multiple breach points. But they're going to stay back here and they're going to wait for whatever reason. They do eventually charge forward, but not right away. All All right, so it seems like the framage is getting a little better. Oh, man, look at that front line. Oh, that's just Total War Attila for you. It's very unfortunate that it's poorly optimized, but there is a tough fight going on for this breach point. My AI is doing a pretty good job, and he is also, well, actually, we got a charge from House Lannister over on this side as well. We have some Umber Light Swordsmen trying to protect this this position, and we have more Swordsmen coming over this way. Looks like it's some heavy swordsmen from Mormont. So look at them all. Oh, yeah, they're pouring in, ready to defend the breach point against House Lannister. A great opportunity to kill some Lannisters this day. It's always a good opportunity. So they're going to reform here, prepared to defend those choke points. Here comes more spearmen from Glover. House Glover charging in. He's got a lot of reserves just sitting back here. And it seems like we're pushing back House Lannister. And you can see, if we look up here, Tyrell is freaking out up on the walls. There is some fighting going on. I think it looks like we have some light infantry taking on their heavy infantry. They do not stand a chance, even with the arrow tower support. And then I have my javelins over here, my Bracken javelins. Look, oh my god, they have incredible range. Let's see here. Let's watch the point of view of these soldiers as they get harassed by the Javis. Oh, and they're getting... Oh, yeah. There we go. Look at them just drop. And they're getting harassed by the Arrow Tower. So it's not good for House Tyrell just losing troops carelessly. Oh, there's another volley right into the backs there. Fantastic. So he's going to fall back this way. And there we go. Finally, he's moving up his troops. The AI, they realize that they need to get going. And they're going to support House Lannister in their epic breach assault. Let's zoom in once more. Slow down the camera a little bit. Yeah, this is going to get real nasty frame-wise and violence-wise. Just that the AI, not only does the AI, like, with all the extra troops, it makes it super laggy, but also when the AI makes decisions, it makes it super laggy. Maybe not so much for the replay, but, you know, the AI trying to calculate everything, it does make it pretty crazy. But finally, I have my troops getting into position. I've got some of my my Malister Light Swordsmen moving up. So they're not going to, like... They're not going to defeat the enemy, but it's nice to have extra bodies in the front line just in case things start to go bad over there. I also have some archers who are about to put down the hurt on House Lannister. They are using heavy shot. All right, there goes their volley. Let's see how much damage they can do here. It's going to be kind of hard to see, but oh my god, here comes Tyrell. And here comes the arrows coming in. Oh, this is just a mess. This is just a mess. So the AI are kind of killing each other at this point. Jackie Fish and myself were saving our army for the final fight, the last stand. And look at the shadows. Look at the shadows are glitching out over here. All right, so Tyrell really trying to push that way. We've got a lot of Lannister troops trying to break through this breach point as well. Go ahead and zoom in here. Oh, look at the white outline around the soldiers. That's funny. Oof. Then we got a pretty huge gate battle. The oil is still active, so it's going to burn a lot of troops over here. House Glover, they have the main objective of defending the gates. That is their main duty in this siege. They are getting outflanked by House Tyrell. He's using the stairs on the walls, being able to flank around. We also have a small fight over here. This is House Tyrell taking on some Umber swordsmen, I believe. some umber heavy spearmen, actually. So yeah, AI really going after each other. I've got archers in the back here supporting that fight as well. So there they go. Firing down, probably getting tons of kills. Archers, okay, one thing to remember, they might change it by the time this game releases, but longbows are so broken. They are so devastating. They do so much damage. They get so many kills. So unless it changes, when you guys get this game, longbows all the way, because they just murder armies. It's sad. It's sad how good they are. So I made sure to bring a lot of longbows in this fight. I want to enjoy this fight, but the shadows are freaking out over here. Jeez. What in the world? There's something doing that. What's causing that? I don't know. When I zoom out, it doesn't happen. But if we look back at my position here, I still have my archers, my longbows. Oh, there goes the tower. Look at that. Yep. He's taking out the towers with the siege equipment there. But yeah, my archers still going to town. I've got my my swordsman, Malister heavy swordsman, moving forward. These guys look awesome. So they're going to join the fight in the front line, because House Lannister and House Tyrell, they are making a great push into the front line. And then over on this side, still a pretty good fight here. I think we're holding. We do have some House Tyrell. Actually, we have Mace Tyrell. They're charging in their general. Mace Tyrell. He's going into the fight. Wow. So yeah, he's going to try to help his men break through this choke point here. Not the bridge battle, but the gate battle is still pretty nasty, but we're holding. We got a ton of bodies keeping back their force, their invading force. See their battle line there. All right, let's see what's going on this flank. Still a lot of House Tyrell, but I am still focusing a lot of arrows over on this position. Also, if you look up here, the arrow tower is also firing down some troops. Oh, look at this. They're actually using the walls. They're actually using their options here. And I do have my heavy spearmen protecting this area, because they went down in this little staircase here. And they're actually trying to take out my archers, but they must get through my spears first. Oh, geez. And I do have some javelin support, which... Actually, they used up most of their ammo. I'm moving them over to this flank. Bracken. House Bracken. That's a very awesome sigil. Oh, jeez. Just wrecked that unit there. And now I'm out of ammo. So what I'm going to try to do is get around that unit. And unfortunately, he has a couple of single troops here that's preventing that. So I do apologize about the framiness, guys. Again, that's Total War Attila for you, but it will smooth out as more people die in this battle. Okay, so Lannister, House Tyrell, they are slowly but surely breaking through this choke point. I sent up more infantry to help protect it, but it doesn't seem good. So what I'm doing here is that I'm forming shield wall with some Bracken heavy swordsmen. So they're gonna form up here, defend this small gap, and I'm also defending this position right here. I took the barricade here. Pretty cool, pretty awesome looking. And then behind them, I do have some javelin support. So hopefully they can hold out for a while. And then of course I'm defending this flank as well. So at this point, I decided to move forward my catapult. My original plan was that I'm going to keep them in the town center for the final push, the final last stand. But I decided that this would be the best time. There's no other time that the armies will be this clumped up. So I better use this catapult now. So I am moving it a little bit closer to get some good hits. And let me tell you, it gets some fantastic hits. So I cannot wait for that artillery slaughter. But soon, not yet, but soon. Yeah, House Tyrell really just spamming in their troops. I'm trying to take advantage of the situation. Just trying to kill off a bunch of troops with one unit. You know, it takes less troops to defend than to attack, obviously. So you can see that you got House Malastur. You can see their purple shields. Just trying to hold back this horde. But they're really struggling just because they're pushing with the just brute force. And I've got my shield wall over here, my Testudo, ready to brace against that massive ocean of men that are going to go pouring in. Oh, what are my swordsmen doing? Are they falling back? Maybe that was a misclick. You see how they were falling back there? No, they're gonna hold their ground. And pretty soon, guys, pretty soon, the catapult here, the onager, is gonna fire. I'm just gonna get it about right here in the street. That should give me a good angle, a good distance to take out their forces. Let's see what's going on over here. The forces are actually thinning out over here. We got a thin line of Umber Heavy Spearmen taking on a horde of Tyrell, horde of swordsmen. Some fire arrows coming in from the arrow tower. Lots of archer support. You can see a lot of bloodied up soldiers. Look at that. And that's not even from melee. That's just from archers. So things are a little calmer over here, even though there's still a ton of invaders. But I do have my my spears ready to go. They're a little depleted because they were having a bit of a battle over here, but they are victorious and they're going to go back to defending this street. And I have my javelin men close behind because they used up all their ammo. Alright, so let's head over to this way because it looks like we are about to fire. So here we go, boys. Oh yes, the artillery is on its way. Look at this battle. And the first shot is going to be a direct hit. And we are going to evaporate their forces. And look at the amount of dead on the battlefield. That is disgusting. There's so many dead troops. This has been a great battle, a fantastic battle so far. We were really enjoying this. Now, Jackie Fish, he was not enjoying the catapults, but I was, so, you know. What can you do? Haters gonna hate, you know what I'm saying? Oh, here comes another volley. Oh, please. Please get some good hits. Nope, a little too far. But this one. Oh, wait, we did get a direct hit there. So more troops burning over here. Oh, the walls are actually crumbling. I didn't mean to hit my own walls, but it does break down that wall, which is unfortunate for those troops who are up on it. But House Malastur, with what's left of their troops, trying to defend back against this horde, buying more time for the catapult to fire. Let's get rid of the HUD. Hopefully that will help with some of the frames. Got some Tyrell calf charging in. Oh my god! Direct hit right on that blob. That was so good. So we are causing major morale destruction right now. Not only are we destroying their bones, their dreams, we are also destroying their morale, which is always a good thing. And now, oh, the archer fire. It's just so many archers coming down in this one spot. I mean, this is such a great kill zone. A fantastic kill zone. Oh, yes. Look at that. Oh, my God. It's almost like explosive rounds. So, yeah, doing tons of damage. Over this way, they've broken through. They're storming through. The floodgates have opened. We're still holding at the gate, which is not great because they are about to be outflanked here by that that floodgate of troops. So it's been a tough fight over at this gate, but it's not going to last for too long. I was able to hold off that Tyrell force on the flank. You can see that most of them are breaking. My archers just really cleaned them up, and my spears were able to hold their ground, even though they were depleted, able to hold their ground and break it. We'll do a massive chain route against these troops. Seems like the frames are getting a lot better already, which is really exciting because we're not even halfway through this battle. And my Malastur heavy swordsman, I don't even remember this when I was playing this. How strong. Oh! More artillery coming in. That's what I like to see. But yeah, I don't remember them holding out for this long. It's kind of crazy. Just buying more and more time for that catapult, which is doing a beautiful job. And just look at all the... Oh, come on, let me zoom out here. All right, there we go. Now they're going to storm in. Now they're going to go into my men who are in testudo formation, which looks amazing. Oh, here comes another shot. I'm almost out of ammo at this point, which is not good, but I think I used my ammo well-deserved. You know, not well-deserved. I think I used my ammo wisely. Yeah, I think this was a good situation, is what I was trying to say, to use the ammo for the catapult. Oh, God, another good hit back there. Excellent, excellent. Come on, hold. Yes, hold, warriors, hold. Oh, more shots coming in. Oh, that one comes short. It's now burning one of my buildings, which could hurt my morale. Yeah, things are already getting better frame-wise. All right, so these guys are going to hold out for a while. Over this way, if you notice, there's a bunch of dead soldiers here. He hasn't attacked yet. He's just using his archers. So I've got myself in testudo, and I've got my archers close by. But they are getting shredded right now by three units of longbowmen from House Lannister. So that is not a good sight. So he's already putting down some archer fire. But I'm okay with that, because if he can use up all of his ammo now instead of using it for my final stand, you can see I've got a lot of reserves back here. Obviously, they're going to be, you know, defending the town center if they are able to push to the town center. But yeah, use up that archer fire, and then I won't have to worry about it late game. But he is destroying the center defense, so I'm going to have almost nothing to defend this barricade. All right, look at this horde of troops. And just look at the death over at this town center, or not town center, but this choke point. This breach point. My goodness. It would smell like iron over here. It'd smell disgusting. But my one unit of swordsmen holding back so many numbers, buying time. I'm pretty sure my catapult, it's used up all its ammo. Yeah, it's used up all its ammo. And now the center. There's a couple of troops fighting for the center near the gate. But it doesn't look like we're going to be able to reclaim it. And most of my AI's army is destroyed. Oh, but what is this? What is this? Is the AI actually using tactics and strategy? Yes, indeed. We have archers up on the wall. So the AI is actually using the walls to use the archers. It is firing. Look at it destroying House Lannister. You can see some fallen soldiers here. Jackie Fish is moving in, moving testudo, or attacking testudo, trying to protect his men here, which looks awesome. God, I love the testudo. It's just so cool. And they make a pretty cool sound effect when you go into testudo. They're like, ooh, ooh. And you hear the clashing of shields. Oh, yeah, we destroyed Tyrell's general. There they go, invading in. Ready to take the walls. Man, this wall has seen a lot of death this day. We are still standing victoriously over here, but with a small handful of troops. They are kneeling, they are tired, and they must stand their ground. Well, they're fresh, but you know what I mean. Role-playing wise, they are tired. Alright, so we continue to hold on. I do have some House Malister light swordsmen in the mix. But again, I'm just buying time for the archers. My longbowmen have used up their ammo. I think I've got another unit of archers. Oh, yes, but they've also used up their ammo. And then I think the archer unit over on this side also used up their ammo. What kind of formation is this? Look at this. Yeah, I've got some heavy swordsmen. Now, I originally sent these heavy swordsmen to defend this street, but I felt like there was really no use to it, because there's no way I was gonna win or do a lot of or get a lot of kills at the front line, because it's pretty much lost. You can see Lannister and Tyrell, they're just running all over the place. Really, we're only defending right here and then in the center, but with a small amount of troops. So I felt like it was better to just send these guys back and use them for the final stand. So my heavy swordsmen, they're falling back, and they should make it in time without any harassment. I do have some light cav left over. Unfortunately, they wasted a lot of their javelins on retreating troops, which is a little frustrating. You gotta make sure you turn off skirmish mode, or not skirmish mode, but fire at will whenever you have skirmishing troops, because sometimes they waste their ammo on targets that don't need to be wasted on, if you know what I mean. But yeah, the archers still going to town here. See, what are they? Are they firing at this unit now? Yes, they are. Let's watch the point of view here. Oh man, look at the fortress from this point of view. That is so cool. The lighting of this battle looks fantastic. Oh, yeah, here they come. Here comes the arrows. Getting a couple hits here and there. So it's good to see that. You know, the AI is weakening up, you know, softening up House Lannister. Because he still has a ton of troops. I mean, look at this. This is almost a full army. And he still has a catapult, so I'm going to have to deal with that too. And this is, well, let's see what I got left. House Lannister, they're charging in. They're here to destroy the barricade. They've almost destroyed it. Looks a little goofy, but you know, it's all right. I got my javelins close by. Where are they? Here they are. Trying to throw their javies at the enemy. So let's see what's happening here. It's so goofy seeing them try. Oh, there we go. All right, I thought my guys died there, but no, they just fall down a little bit. And now they're gonna go into melee and defend what's left of this barricade. Alright, so now I've got my light cav, and at this point of the battle, I was looking for an opportunity to take out these archers, because I was so afraid of them, because they can get so many kills. So I was just looking for an opening somewhere where I could charge in, but it looks like Jackyfish is really defending. He's got troops almost at every angle, protecting his archers. I was even thinking about going outside, but he has his unit of heavy cav close by, so that wouldn't be any good. So for now, I just wait. And my ally is still firing his bows over here at Jackyfish's army. Jackyfish now moving in more infantry because he needs to quickly take out the position because my ally's archers is wrecking his reserves. I wouldn't say wrecking, but he's hurting his reserves. So this is pretty intense fight over here, still going on. And it goes on for quite some time. Just endless amount of troops from House Tyrell. Look at that. And they're all cheering. Because it's been such a tough push for the attackers to get into this position. To actually break through and get to the second part of my defense. Which is over here. I have more swordsmen. The swordsmen that I was retreating, they finally reached the town center and they can rest up, prepare their defenses. And now what's left of my spearmen, unfortunately, they are getting attacked by two small units from House Tyrell and House Lannister. But they should hold on for a little bit longer. You can see there's some archer support again from my ally, my AI ally. Overall, he's been pretty stupid, but he's done a couple good things. Or she, you know, or it, AI, whatever. Did you just assume the AI's gender? Okay, moving on. So the fight in the center, still pretty intense. I just got a handful of troops fighting them back. Oh. So there was a total of 9,000 troops on Jackyfish's side. He's now down to about 4,000, a little less. I had 7,000. I'm now down to 2,200. Oh, my ally is breaking. So really, my ally is down to his general. And the AI always leave their general at the town center, which is good for me. You know, like, just having a couple extra horses over there is always great for the final stand. But yeah, it's not looking good. The balance of power is way in favor of Jackyfish, and it's looking pretty bleak at this point. Uh, All right, but this fight, it keeps going, man. It doesn't end. It does not end. Tyrell still has an ocean of troops over here. I really wish I had another catapult, but you know, I could only bring one. I'd rather have more swordsmen than just a bunch of catapults. It's nice to see some good frames over here. Yeah, but Lannister slowly inching forward through this position. And unfortunately, my spearmen, they fought to the death. Well, that's not the unfortunate part. They're very brave. Bless their souls. But unfortunately, they are all dead. And now there is an opening to my city. So what they can do now is actually flank around and get behind my forces. So that's not going to be good for my swordsmen who have been defending this area for a long time against such a massive number of troops. That brutal front line. All right, you can see Jackie Fish. He's running down some of my allies' archer unit here. They pretty much used up their ammo, but that's so you know it's not a big deal that they're getting cut down because they used their ammo. So it's not like they're going to be that effective in melee. You can see they're just getting trashed by that Lannister cav. Yeah, so they're breaking on through. That's going to be it for them. Lannister running through the streets here. Again, trying to get behind the flank so the rest of his army can push through. Most of his forces are pretty close to the gate. And just look at it's just littered with dead bodies. Lannister, unfortunately, he came up the walls here, destroyed the archers that were up on the walls. So good job from Jackie Fish. This was a brutal defense. And this is just, it's so cool to see this because the ground is white. And all the bodies, you know, they're a darker color, so you can easily see them. And it's just, it's insane the amount of dead, especially right here, just a blob of dead soldiers. And we barely hang on. This is our final stand right here because the center is breaking. And here comes House Lannister pushing through. Gonna take out some of my javelin men over here. And they're... I guess my javies weren't looking the right way. That's all right. They're pretty much useless at this point. So I have some light cav. I was thinking about, I was trying to set up a trap right here. I was hoping that Jackie Fish, he would charge in troops, go down the street, and then I would charge in with my cav. But Jackie Fish, he knows better. He's going to charge in his cav, not charge in infantry, so I cannot surround him. And now he's going to get a pretty... nasty cav charge, and I know it. And at this point, I was like, you bastard, leave my swordsmen alone, because this is the only way he's going to break through this position right here, is by attacking the backs of my swordsmen. So I was just like, screw you, charging in my archers, and gets a nasty charge on my archer force. I was trying to nerf his charge by charging in, closing the gap, but he charged in too soon, and I was not able to do that. House Lannister breaking their way through. Very, very unfortunate. And there's that cheer. All right, so what they're going to do now is charge the back of my swordsmen, who are so desperately holding on. They can see the cav behind them. They know they're going to die this day, but they're going to take out as many. Oh, there it is. They're going to take out as many as they can. And my swordsmen are fighting back to back, taking on such reckless hate. What can men do? Oh, this is where I tried to do a sneaky cav charge into his archers. Dang it, I forgot to show you this. It's not successful, but it was close. And this is where I get pretty salty against Jackie Fish. I was like, dang it, how did you see that? So what I was doing is that I had some light cav going around this way. So using the streets here. He did not have this troop right here, and I had a perfect opening. But he saw my advance, and he pushed up Tywin Lannister. So he's using his own general to defend his archers and his catapult. And unfortunately, my light cav is going to get cut down against this superior general bodyguard. But they're putting up a fight, you know? They're doing all right. They're doing all right. And unfortunately, my swordsmen, who I will most certainly sing a song about, are going to die here because they are surrounded. We will build a statue of them. We will remember the brave 200 men who defended this street for 15 minutes, which is pretty long in terms of Total War Attila. Very nice. I will remember you. Die honorably. Die with dignity. What a horrible... Oh, there they go. They're breaking. The men are cheering. Look at this. Huzzah! They're so relieved. They can finally break through and push their advance. And now I am down to my final defense. I've got my troops ready here. I did do a cav charge over here with my general just to try to get some early kills. Really wasn't that effective because the general bodyguard, they don't have lances, so they don't get that impressive of a cav charge. But what do I have left? I have some Malister heavy swordsmen, House Malister, and then I have some swordsmen on this side. And then I have two units of spears protecting this flank. I have some light cav, which I'm probably going to dismount. I have my general and two archers. And that's it. That's it. He still has 3,600. I have 1,500. So we are greatly outnumbered. Not looking good. But the good news is we still have these longbows. They're going to get a ton of kills. They're just so good. The final push. It will be decided right here. Can we hold out? Do we have enough to chain route the enemy? See the arrows coming in. And he's going to use his numbers just to push through my forces. Look at that. He's trying. But it really wasn't too effective. I think it's a little bit more effective in Medieval 2, to be honest. And here comes Tywin Lannister, keeping the spirits high for his own troops. I've got a secondary layer of swordsmen watching this street. So if I do lose this unit, I'll have another layer to defend my forces. We're good and slow down the camera panel over this epic sword fight. I just love seeing the random arrows fly in and get some kills. Alright, so I saw Tywin. He is actually headed over this way to the other flank. We do have some House Lannister swordsmen trying to go through every breach, as many breaches as possible, trying to break down my defense. That is always the best idea whenever you're trying to take out a Total War Attila town center, which are usually really easy to defend. You want to try to attack on all sides, so you really use up the defender's forces there. Alright, so he's really trying to spread my troops thin, essentially. Oh, that volley of arrows. Excellent, excellent. Getting some very, very vital kills there. Critical kills. And he's pouring in more troops. My archers are focusing down on this blob. We can see House Tyrell moving in. A lot of depleted Lannister forces coming in. This is their point of view. They are exhausted. They're tired. They're cold. They're bloodied up. They just want to go home. But they must destroy the rebellion. Pretty cool charge right there. Here is House Lannister. Alright, so here we go. They're moving in. They're going to take on my spears, which are in, well, they're not quite in shield wall formation yet. It looks like this unit is. There's that nice shield wall. Oh, there we go. Did you hear that? That was so cool. They're standing right next to the statues. These guys are a bit out of position, but that's okay. What is my ally's general doing? He's disrupting my formation. What the heck, man? Oh, then we got some artillery coming in. He's going after my archers who are trying to make the last stand. And it looks like he's also using his own archer fire to try to take out my archers, which is, you know, a smart idea. Still holding over here, which was really impressive. Because he's attacking with so many forces. Now he's really trying to push in with his numbers. Again, my swordsmen continue to stand their ground. They do not waver to the sight of so many troops. My archers are just firing left and right to different groups of soldiers. Right now, they're focused to the flank of House Lannister. And let's see what's going on over here. We have some troops coming up this way. We got some heavy swordsmen moving up this way. I've got my small defense over here of heavy swordsmen. Heavy swordsmen v heavy swordsmen. I should have the advantage because I do have the high ground. And my troops are well rested. His are winded. And then my archer unit back here, they're firing at the big blob that's actually fighting on this side. So my troops are really thinning out. They're down to 124, which is actually not that bad considering how long they've been fighting. More archer fire coming in. Tywin is close by, keeping the troops' spirits high. Oh man, what can you do against such reckless hate? My spears are taking on these troops here. They're doing all right. They should be able to hold. The spears in this game can hold for so long. Oh, we actually have some wavering here from House Tyrell. Some medium spearmen that are breaking. So I'm feeling pretty confident on this flank because it's pretty even numbers. There goes my light cav there. They're gonna form a shield wall. Just in case this shield wall breaks, which it doesn't look like it's going to break. Yeah, it looks like they're going to hold for a while, just because the numbers are pretty even. But they are sending up more troops, which is a little concerning. But it's alright, we should still be able to hold. Really, my biggest issue is right here. That right there, that's a big issue. So I was like, dang it, Jackie, like why? Why you gotta destroy my men like that? So I break Testudo and I'm just gonna join the fight over here. Instead of waiting in reserve, the best thing to do in those kind of situations is just to charge your men into the fight. That way, if he tries to fire at your men with a catapult, then he risks killing his own men, some friendly fire. So you gotta just be aggressive in those kind of situations. So now I have another layer of defenders protecting this choke point. The final stand, it's still going. Still going, and it's gonna go on for another 17 minutes. But House Tyrell actually putting a dent into my forces over here. My spears, I have 143 over here. And then this unit right here has 180. So you can see that they're really focusing on this spear unit. Got my archers now focusing down on this blob. Come on, hold spears, hold! How terrifying would it be, like... having to fight in one choke point and then knowing that there's another choke point where they're fighting over and just praying that all the choke points hold, because if one fails, then the defense is over. There's no way you can win. So a lot of blood on the battlefield this day. A lot of dead bodies, a lot of death and destruction, which is always good to see. His archers have used... Oh my god, the lag. His archers have used up his ammo, but he still has the catapult ammo. So I think pretty soon he's going to move it forward. Let's see, what is he doing here? Is he about to fire? He is firing, but where is he going after? Oh my goodness. Yes, it's going to hit his men. No, it hits the tower. Oh man, I was so upset about that. That would have wrecked his army. That could have potentially broken all of the troops right there. But it's saved by this tiny tower that is now on fire. Just a symbol of my luck in this battle. Which is no luck at all. I make my own luck. General's still alive, just waiting for a good opportunity. I'm keeping him on horseback because you never know when you'll have an opportunity to charge out your cav and do a hammer and anvil or something like that. Still holding over here, which is excellent. Which is wonderful. Alright, let's see how this flank is holding, because this is the most important flank. It's still holding, and it's still going to hold for a pretty long time. Such a brutal front line right here. Tywin Lannister still over here trying to keep his men's spirits high. My archers still have a little bit of ammo left. I'm focusing my ammo on the catapult crew because I'm so desperately trying to kill this catapult. I am not looking forward to it. Let's see if we can do any damage here. Let's watch the volley. Originally I was in heavy shot, but I'm going to go to standard shot because it's a faster rate of fire. And it's not like these guys need heavy shot. They have very light clothes on, barely even armor. So it should be pretty easy to kill them. Just got to keep up that rate of fire and take them out. There we go. We're getting a couple kills here. Oh, this poor guy. Look at this guy. He's crawling. Someone take him out of his misery. Someone kill him. No, no. Oh, you hear that? There's an ambulance in the background. There's an ambulance. well timed. He needs an ambulance. So yeah, trying to break them. They are eager, so they're not close to breaking. So we might have to kill them all with my archer support. But unfortunately, I'm running low of ammo. And look at this, the general... From the north, he is charging out. His name is Great John Umber. So he's the Umber House General. He's now joining this fight, which is actually a well-timed assault by the general, because my troops are starting to thin out over here. So I was pretty good. I was pretty happy about that. I was like, all right. Yeah, my AI is pretty smart in this battle. He's done some good things. Over here, we're still holding on. Again, this is not an issue. Actually, they're wavering, House Tyrell. They're shaken. They're exhausted. And then we got some forces over here. My archers still just... What are they firing at? I'm not sure. Maybe they're holding fire? No, we got a couple firing. There we go. Looks like they're firing at this blob of forces here. My general dismounted. And now he's in the fight because my spears are thinning out greatly over here. So... Hopefully we can push him back with the support of the general. Zoom in here, get a nice close-up of this intense fight. On this side, the fight continues on. I have my light cavalry that I dismounted a long time ago. They're now going to be reserves in this fight. And poor House Lannister, poor Jackie Fish, so desperately trying to break through here. But I will not budge. He has taken the high ground, though. Yeah, he's really just trying to push through all the gaps here, trying to get around my troops. But it's not going to happen this day. Not today. And some of my archers have used up all of their ammo, which is not great. I need every single arrow. I need more ammo to take out these men. Oh, the catapults are now firing again, and he's going for the back unit over here. He actually kills his own troops there. He does burn some of my own troops. But that was a really gutsy move there. What he's trying to do, though, is if he can break through this one unit, he's going to be able to attack all my other troops at the flank. Here comes another shot. Oh, man, I am just getting so lucky. So lucky in this situation. He has not had he hasn't gotten a direct hit yet, except for on his own troops. There goes the tower that was burning over here. The fire is floating in air. And his infantry will surely lose morale now because of that friendly fire. But my swordsmen are regrouping after that very intense artillery shot. And they continue to hold. And he is officially out of ammo with his archers and his artillery. And it's all up to his heavy infantry to break through my lines. And we're actually pushing House Lannister back from whence they came from. Slaughtered that one, but you get what I'm saying. Uh-oh, our ally's general, he has been slain on the battlefield, but that's okay. Because he doesn't have an army. He doesn't really affect anyone. So it's not like he had any troops helping us defend this. Can't believe we're still fighting over here. It's amazing how many troops we're holding back. But over on this side, we are thinning. We are thinning. There's 8 minutes left in the battle. Can we hold on for dear life? Can we hold back House Lannister and break their spirits? My general is back on horseback. Now, originally, the reason why I have him on horseback, he was fighting here before, but I sent the archers who used up all their ammo to fill in the gap. I was going to get him back on horses and try to flank around this way since there's now an opening. You can see them running down here. But then I realized there's no way to get over here. There's just a bunch of houses. So there's no way I could have gotten Hammer and Anvil, which would have been game over. If I could have gotten my general back here, it would have been end of the battle. But unfortunately, the only way to get to the enemy is going around this way. And we have Tywin Lannister defending this road. So I wasn't going to risk a general v general fight. I was just going to send him back and just use him as more infantry to defend the choke points. I do have my reserve infantry, the ones that are victorious on the other choke point. They are now joining this fight. Just needed them in time. They showed up just in time. And this rebellion lives on after almost an hour of fighting. So many brave units have lost their lives in this battle. Men that we shall remember. There we go. We got some troops breaking over here. They're just archers. They're just longbows, but that's okay. That is okay. The balance of power. Look at it. What am I... Like, seriously, how am I still hanging on? Look at that balance of power. I'm down to 630 troops. He's down to 1,300. This is insane that my army is still holding on for dear life. But House Lannister, they are finally breaking through this position, and now they are about to attack my final reserve of light cavalry. I do have my general though, but I don't really want to risk my general dying, so I'm trying to keep him back from the fight for as long as possible. I love the fish scales there. That looks cool. Anyways. Anyways, the general's bodyguard for the north here, Umber. Great John Umber. They're still fighting. There's still a ton of troops for House Lannister, but we've killed a ton in this situation. I can't believe it's this close. That's 575 against 1,200. We're just relying on them to break. Here comes more archers coming in. They're returning from breaking. They're not really going to do much here. My archers, they still have a little bit of ammo left. Doesn't look like they're firing though. I guess they're holding their fire. It could be the heavy shot. Obstructed. Oh, I guess there's something in their way. A couple of them are firing. Like one or two. There they go. Now they're gonna fire. See, what are they firing at? Oh, they're firing at the big blob of Lannister. Big blob of Lannister. There we go. Oh, nice. We took out a ton there. Where's Tywin? Oh, I see. Okay, I'm getting back on my horse here because Tywin Lannister, I thought he was going to flank around, but Jackyfish decides not to go that way because there is an opening here that nobody's defending, nobody's attacking. So I had to retreat my general and get him back to the other side. But then I realized Tywin is coming over this way. So I'm going to send my general back to face Tywin. We can see a lot more breaking over here as well. It's really close, really down to the wire. It is really down to the wire. And now I have a thin... Oh, I'm using fire arrows now. Using fire arrows to try to break their morale. Cause them to chain route. That's my only hope at this minute, or at this point of the battle. We're down to 4 minutes. Blackfish, he's getting into position. He's going to dismount here and join this fight. Because Tywin, he is also joining the fight over here. And this is it. This is going to decide the battle right here, right now. Can my men hold, or will they be crushed? Oh, look at, he's just pushing through with his numbers. Look at that. Dismount, men. For the rebellion. For the north. For independence. Sort of. There they go. Charging in. General is now fully committing to the fight. I'm focusing down my archers at this big blob. There is a chance to killing his general. I could kill Tywin over here. Look at that. Look at that. Using his horses just a breakthrough. There goes my allies' men. They are all gone, evaporated from the battlefield. My general stopping a horde of troops. If we look on the other side, look at this, guys. Look at this. They are breaking. We are winning over here. But still, the balance of power greatly in favor of Jackyfish. But do we have enough to break Lannister? They're down to 26 men. Why are they not breaking? I was so desperate for them to break. And this is such a close fight over here. Look at the banner of House Lannister, all bloodied up, all dirty. And there we go. There we go. His troops are breaking. We have a couple of Tyrell, which are down to like 24 men, 23 men. I'm charging in more forces this way. I'm actually retreating a unit of infantry that were victorious over on that side. They're down to 74 troops, but I need more men over here to support the general. Tywin Lannister, he's trying to break through still with brute force. I actually still have the heavy swordsman, Malister, House Malister heavy swordsmen that were fighting originally at that choke point. They're still fighting. Look, you can see their purple shield right there. That is awesome. Oh, and there goes my general's cav. They're freaking out. They're getting out of here. And here's the final push. The final push of House Lannister. Will they have enough to take us out? I don't think so. We stand with the Blackfish. No mercy. Oh, look at him. Look at him. Just so, he's so desperate to break through. If we view what's going on over here, I actually had to commit my archers because I think I prematurely retreated there with my swordsmen. I should have left them in the fight. So now I had to send in my archers to hold back this small group of troops. My archers have a good chance of winning this because we already have some swordsmen breaking and they're very depleted. So we can still win over there. And this is what's left right here. Right here. And we have yet to kill the general, but he's got to be close. I don't even know where he is. But there is the banner of the general, the Blackfish. House Tully. Look at wavering troops. Wavering troops all over the place. We got two wavering House Lannister swordsmen there breaking. Come on, kill his general. Oh, and that's it. It's a draw. Well, honestly, I would have won that one if there was more time because his general was killed at that point, and there was a massive chain route. So both me and Jackie Fish, we agreed to... we agreed that I would have won that one if there was more time. But, yeah, really close. And I cannot believe I turned that one around. I thought I was going to lose for sure. But what an absolute bloody battle. And we're going to go ahead and end this one. What a grind fest. I mean, down to the wire. And the amount of kills that my archers got here. Look at this. 837, which is insane. 746. Some of my swordsmen getting a decent amount, like 337, 355, 269, 145. Artillery getting 179. They probably got more, but it doesn't count the burning of the troops. And yeah, overall, my army did pretty well. My general doing pretty well there too. My ally getting some good kills with his archers. Here's Jackie Fish's kills here. It looks like he has some infantry that did pretty well, 333. His archers doing all right, getting 200 plus. And then his allies' army not doing as good, but yeah, actually getting some good kills here and there. But I'm gonna wrap this up because this is such a long battle. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this one, and I will see you next time in the next glorious battle.